Good morning, friends, and welcome back to Grove Kids. I am so glad that you came back to hang out with us this morning. Now, before we jump into our Bible story for this week, we're going to talk about something that is very, very important. The past few weeks, we've been talking about how God's people were constantly choosing sin over and over and over again. We know that when sin entered the world through Adam and Eve, it was in every human that was born after them. And that means that sin is still in our world today. So let's remember, what is sin? Sin is anything we do, say, or think that doesn't please God. Now, we've talked before about how we can see sin in a lot of different ways, but this week, I want us to talk about how we see the effects of sin in regards to race and people who might not look like you. Now, Genesis 1:27 says, "So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them." This verse from the Bible tells us that every person, whether they have brown skin, black skin, or white skin, was made in the image of God. Now, an image is like a picture. So God made all people to be a picture of him. We were made to be like God and to reflect what he is like. Now, we talk a lot about loving God, but it's important that we also talk about loving every single person who was made in his image. And that is everyone, no matter what color their skin is. So, God made every person in his image, every neighbor, friend, classmate, or person you see at the grocery store or on the street was made beautiful to reflect the beauty and the character of God. That means that it's a sin for us to not love every single person like God loves them, because God loves all of us so much. He sent Jesus to die on the cross so that our sinful hearts could be made clean. And when we believe in Jesus, he takes our sick and dirty hearts and changes them to desire what God desires. So, what does this mean for me and for you? Number one, it means that every single person was made in the image of God. Number two, we are called to love every single person, no matter the color of their skin. Number three, if we see someone who isn't being treated with love and respect, it's our job to stand up for that person and love them just like God does. And number four, it's also our job to pray that people in the world who have black skin or brown skin would be treated just like God treats them and loves them. So we're going to do that right now. Then we'll dive into our Bible story for this week. So let's pray. God, thank you for giving us your word so that we can know your truth. We know that all people were created in the image of you to reflect your beauty. So it's our responsibility to treat all people just like you treat them and to love all people just like you do. God, would you protect people in our world who have a different skin color than I do? Would you teach us how to live in a way that shows others that we not only love you, but we love all people that you created? It's in your name we pray. Amen. All right, friends, our big question this month is, why do we pray? We pray because we trust God and we know that he hears us. Did anyone already memorize our new key passage for this week? It seems kind of long, but it's pretty doable, I think. Now, here's a few friends for you, just in case you needed a little bit of help.
Rejoice always.
Pray without teasing.
Now, when we trust in Jesus, we can always be full of joy. We can always rejoice because he is good. This passage reminds us of that, and it also tells us that we can always pray to God when we don't understand what is happening around us, because God is always in control. Now, last week, we talked about how God was with three men in a fire and how he rescued them just like he sent Jesus to rescue us. This week, we are going to learn about the king that put them in that fire, King Nebuchadnezzar. That is a really big name. What if your name was Nebuchadnezzar? But we're going to talk about how God showed that king that he alone is in control. Now, have you ever had a bad dream? I know that I have. Well, one night, King Nebuchadnezzar had a dream. We're going to read about what that dream was. In Daniel chapter 4, verse 10, it says, "I saw, and behold, a tree in the midst of the earth, and its height was great. The tree grew and became strong, and its top reached to heaven, and it was visible to the end of the whole earth. Its leaves were beautiful, and its fruit abundant, and in it was food for all. The beasts of the field found shade under it, and the birds of the heavens lived in its branches, and all flesh was fed from it." King Nebuchadnezzar dreamt about a tree? Have you ever had a dream about a tree? Now, Daniel tells us that the king was still worshiping other things other than the one true God. God didn't want to be just one of the many things that the king worshiped. Remember last week, King Nebuchadnezzar, we talked about, started worshiping God after the men came out of the fire. He wanted the king to know that God was the only true God. So God used this dream to get his attention in a pretty big way. So to find out the rest of that dream, because it doesn't just stop with the really tall tree, and to hear all about what that dream meant, because it seems a little confusing, be sure to go watch our Bible story online. And parents, go take a look at our website for some resources to continue the conversation that we opened up this morning with. Please let us know if you have any questions or if there's any way that we can come alongside your family as you disciple your kids. Now, the big thing for us to remember is that God is the only true God, and he alone deserves glory. We're going to worship him now to give him the glory and praise for being a good God that is always in control. So go ahead and stand up with us to worship and let me hear your voices all over the place this morning as we sing and we dance for joy because God is good and worthy of our worship. I love you guys, and I cannot wait because in just a few weeks, I'll get to see you again. So I love you. I miss you. Here's your virtual high five, and I'll see you very, very soon. Though the tears may fall, my